Mosquitoes. They're a sign of summer in many parts of the U.S. They're also vectors of pathogens, spreading diseases, especially this species, the Aedes aegypti mosquito.
It's really hard to control this mosquito. It's resistant to a lot of the chemical insecticides which can be used for it, and there are no effective vaccines or drugs for most of the diseases which it can actually carry.
So the Florida Keys Mosquito Control District is turning to a novel tool, releasing millions of genetically modified male mosquitoes designed to reduce the population of Aedes aegypti. Here's how it works. It might seem strange that a tool to combat the spread of mosquitoes relies on the release of, well, more mosquitoes. The entire strategy focuses on getting rid of female mosquitoes, since they're the only mosquitoes that bite. Fewer female mosquitoes means fewer eggs, which hopefully means fewer future mosquitoes.
So the OX5034 mosquito, this is what we call our friendly male mosquito. And this male mosquito really has one job, and that's to go and find invasive female mosquitoes, mate with them, and pass on to them two genes.
The first genetic modification they'll pass on to their offspring is found in the TTAV gene.
It's called a self-limiting gene. It stops the development of female mosquitoes that carry this gene. So males can carry the gene, it doesn't impact them at all, but the female offspring that get the self-limiting gene, they're going to die before they become adult female mosquitoes.
The other genetic modification these male mosquitoes will pass on to their offspring will be a color marker.
So we put the DSRED2 gene into our male mosquitoes, and this is a color marker which helps us to tell our mosquitoes apart from the invasive wild ones. So that means that if we've released our male mosquitoes in the field, we can look at any mosquito that we catch and we can see whether it's one of our mosquitoes or not. The other thing we can do is we can look at the offspring of our male mosquitoes. And if they carry this color marker, which is visible under a microscope, then you can tell whether they've actually been fathered by one of the male mosquitoes.
It's a novel approach that specifically targets the Aedes aegypti population. And while the United States is home to more than 200 species of mosquitoes, Aedes aegypti isn't native and is, according to scientists, an annoying biting pest. And the species most responsible for transmitting dengue, chikungunya, yellow fever, and Zika viruses to humans.
So there's a lot of factors that are involved in influencing what makes a mosquito species, such as Aedes aegypti, such a great vector of viruses. Certainly the ability of the virus to pass through all the transmission barriers within the mosquito and go from the midgut of the mosquito to the salivary gland so that it can be able to transmit that virus. When we talk about the extrinsic factors or the factors outside of the mosquito, some of the things that make Aedes aegypti such a wonderful vector of viruses to humans is that it does live in such close association with us. The species is known to take frequent and multiple blood meals. Every time it takes a blood meal from a human, it increases the likelihood of either being able to pick up an infection or, if it's already infected, transmitting that infection to an uninfected person.
The spread of exotic viruses by mosquitoes is a problem in Florida and around the world. Oxytex technology to create a self-limiting mosquito has been a decade in the making.
So genetically modifying any insect is challenging. You have to take the eggs of that insect, put them under a microscope, and then you actually take DNA that carries these genes that we're putting into that insect, and we inject it into those eggs. And then we wait to see if that DNA becomes part of the chromosomes that are in that mosquito egg. And then what we can do is once it's been incorporated into those chromosomes, we can then breed from that genetically modified mosquito. So that's what we did. Back in 2013, we first injected that DNA into these mosquito eggs. And then since then, we've just been breeding from that stock that have incorporated these two genes. But along the way, what we also have to do is we have to do a lot of experiments in the lab to see whether these genes are functioning the way that we expect. So are they killing all the female offspring as we expect? Can we see this color marker properly? And can these mosquitoes mate effectively? Can they fly properly? All the kind of things you need to check before you can go from the lab into the field.
The mosquito eggs are produced in facilities in the UK. Then they're shipped to the project areas. Add water, and in under 2 weeks, you'll have about 1,000 genetically modified mosquitoes.
We've done this in Brazil in the past. We've seen that the neighborhoods where we released our male mosquitoes, we have more than 95% reduction in the mosquito population in that neighborhood.
The release in Florida began in 2021. This year, the Florida Keys Mosquito Control District is approved to release up to 196 million mosquitoes between 2022 and 2023. It'll be monitored by Oxytex and the Mosquito Control District.
These type of trials, they can be expensive. To be able to really monitor the success of these trials, it's going to require a lot of labor to be able to document the impacts of the releases on the multiple stages of the mosquito life cycle or the mosquito populations. And so this is not something that is going to be used everywhere. What I can say is that the best long-term solution for mosquito control is going to be an integrated mosquito management plan that incorporates the multiple tools. For example, using maybe genetically modified mosquitoes, source reduction. That means getting rid of sites around houses or within neighborhoods that could be used as the larval habitat, and then following up with larvicide. Using all these different tools together is going to be the best long-term solution.
The tools typically used to combat mosquitoes, source reduction and insecticide, will need to adapt to the realities of a warming world.
As temperatures increase, then the length of the larval stage is going to decrease. You're going to be able to go through that life cycle faster, and you're going to end up with more mosquitoes. So certainly in these areas that are becoming warmer, it's going to allow for species that like the warmth, like Aedes aegypti, to increase their range and also increase their population size.